Hi everyone, welcome back to part two of our Dark Souls Pyromancy run beginner's guide. So to start, I just want to do a quick intro to item duping in Dark Souls 1. So we're going to start off by item duping Quelaag's Soul up to 110,000 so that we can level our Pyromancy Flame and buy some spells. And I just want to talk you through very quickly what we're going to be doing so that you can see it in action. There's lots of really good videos out there on how to dupe, and I'm sure there's probably info on speed souls and stuff like that. So if you want to work out how to do it, go and hop some videos, but I'm just going to give a really quick overview before we start. So basically, item duping in Dark Souls 1 allows you to use an item that's on your hotbar, but consume the item from your inventory. So what we do is we put Quelaag's Soul on our hotbar, and then when we use it, we override that use with the Estus flask from our start menu. And what this means is that we play the animation for popping Quelaag's Soul and we get 8k, but we actually make the inventory adjustment to the Estus and our number of Estus goes down by 1. And because we can continue to try and queue the Estus even when we have 0 Estus, it means we can just keep playing the soul for the animation for popping Quelaag's Soul over and over and over, and we never consume it. So the way this works is we take advantage of two things. The first is that when you run an action from your hotbar, it queues differently to when you run an action from your inventory. And the second thing is we use Dark Souls' queuing system to take advantage of this. So in Dark Souls, at the end of an action, if you press another action before you exit the animation, it will queue up that action. So for example, if you roll and before you exit the roll, you hit roll again, you will roll as you come out of the other roll. So you don't have to hit it at the precise moment, if that makes sense. So the way we're going to dupe the Soul of Quelaag is that we are going to perform an action. So in this case, we do a roll, but it could equally be a parry, or you can do it from a lever pull or picking up an item. But here we use a roll. And as we get to the end of that roll, then we will hit square to use Quelaag's Soul, which is on our hotbar, and then we go into our start menu and use an Estus. And what that means is when we come out of the roll, we will play the animation for popping the soul, but decrease our Estus count by 1. And as we get to the end of that animation for popping the soul, we do the same thing again. So as the animation finishes, we hit square, star, X, 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 and we'll decrease our Estus by 1, but pop the soul again. Okay, let's get started. So we're 19 minutes, 27 seconds into our run. We've killed Gargoyles, killed Quelaag, leveled up in the Chaos Covenant to open the shortcut, and now we're going to dupe. So we equip the Soul of Quelaag, do a roll, and then we use the item as we get to the end of the roll. Then we use the Estus before that animation plays, and we get the Estus inventory change, but the animation is popping the soul. So here, as I get to the end of the soul popping animation, there, I use the soul again and then do the inventory adjustment. So the keys for this would be, when the hand comes down, square star XXX. So the hand pops, and as it comes down, square star XXX. And what that means is the soul pop gets queued up, but then what actually happens in the inventory adjustment is that an Estus gets used. So my Estus is going down all the time, but you can continue to try and use Estus even when you're at zero. So we just rinse it all the way through until we get to 110, and then we go to Engi, modify equipment, and we upgrade our Pyromancy Flame to plus 12. So a couple of notes here. If you're not confident in, like, I chose plus 12 because after plus 12, the Pyromancy Flame gets really expensive, so you have to spend much more time popping the soul. And plus 12 is enough to get through most of the early game. The only thing you're really going to have a problem with is later on. So I think upgrading to plus 12 is fine. If you're not confident, you can continue to pop Quelaag's Soul and go up to kind of 160 or 180k, and you can ascend your Pyromancy Flame all the way up to plus 15, and then if you wanted, you could use the extra souls to level as well. We are going to use the Dark Sign to Dark Sign out of here, but you'll keep Quelaag's Soul, so when you get back to Firelink, you could very easily just start popping it again and use that to rest and level up at Firelink if you wanted to. But yeah, I went for plus 12. And you need to make sure that you've got, I think you need 27k or 26k left over, because we're going to buy Combustion, Great Combustion, and Great Fireball from Quelaana. Incidentally, some of you may never have even seen Qailana. So she appears in Blighttown once you get to a plus 10 pyromancy flame. So you need to get a minimum of plus 10 to make her appear, but she appears immediately. So we've joined the Chaos Covenant, upgraded, and now we can run back here. So we'll quit out to avoid the aggro from the ogres, then reload, buy what we need, and we'll use the Dark Sign to go all the way back to Firelink.
Are you? Yes.
Two things worth mentioning. Both Engi and Qailana, their opening dialogue options, the default is no, so you need to make sure that you don't rush for it too quickly, because you've got to press left and then select in order to get yes. So now we're here, we're gonna run to the lift and take the lift to the church. Once we get onto the lift, we need to pop the soul four times, and then we'll actually consume it to finish, because we don't need it anymore. So here I'm going to use a roll to roll into the lift, and then at the end of the animation I try and pop. Unfortunately, I mess it up, so I don't hit use on the item, so I have to roll again. Because I made that mistake, I'm going to come off the lift a little bit late, but you actually have just the right amount of time to dupe it four times and then pop it to get yourself the 40k? I guess 40k that you need. So here's the last usage, and that'll take us to 40, and then we run out. We're going to use that 40k to level up our attunement so that we can equip the four spells that we've acquired. And then we will also have, I think, just over 21k left over, which allows us to buy a shield from Andre and the key. If you're cheap with your souls, even though you can dupe, you can kill Andre. You can use two Chaos Fireballs to kill him, but it's very easy to go wrong, and he is, like, super hard. So given that we've got just enough time in the lift to pop the soul four times and then consume it, I think it works out quite nicely. So once we've done that, we need to try and equip our Pyromancy Flame and the shield. I am not good at this yet, so my menuing isn't quite fast enough, and this guy, I find it so hard to dodge his attacks. So I try and get past just blocking with the Drake Sword and take the hit. If I get hit, it won't kill me, and then I do my inventory adjustment here. Remember, if you've selected slot 2 on your left hand side, to press left to get your shield up, otherwise you'll sucker punch a tree like I did. When we get to the door, as soon as you do the action on the door to open it, you can quit out immediately, and when you load back in, it'll be open. And that saves us a little bit of time. But perhaps more importantly, it stops us getting killed by the trees while we wait for the door to open. You don't really want to save at the bonfire there if you can avoid it, because you'll just end up having to run back again. So if you can, try to avoid saving there so that you can build your confidence and try and do Sif first time. Here, I talk to the cat to de-aggro the guys. If you want to do it while you continue to run, so just use your middle finger on the circle to keep running, and then use your forefinger to tap X to skip through the dialogue. And that'll allow you to kind of keep pushing forward and not have to move your thumb over. We grabbed the stone armor here, so we're going to use the stone armor for the Four Kings and for Nito, as we do with most runs. And I guess we should talk about strats for Sif. So I find Sif really quite hard. I know a lot of people find it to be a very easy fight. I find it very difficult. He does constant chip damage to you when he jumps all the time, and especially with Pyromancy, it's just really hard to hit him after you roll for his attacks. So the attacks we want from Sif is he has a couple of charge and slash attacks, and we want him to do those so that we can roll through the slash and then hit him on the other side. the way you generally can get Sif to attack you is to run or walk away from him, and then he'll charge you. So we do a little loop. We run away, and then we come back in and attack. Here, make sure you've got full stamina, because when you come out of the animation, your stamina carries over. It doesn't reset in the animation, and you want to make sure you've got enough stamina to soak a hit if you have to. So generally, my strategy with Sif is to roll through his attack and then turn around and point towards his head and try and hit him there. So we're going to use Great Combustion first, and we'll probably burn through all of our Great Combustions, and then we'll need a little something else to finish him off. So as you can see, I'm trying to aim for the area kind of his body above his front paws or his head. Those, to me, feel like the easiest places to hit with Pyromancy. Now we've used our Great Combustions, we need to switch over to either Great Fireball or Great Chaos Fireball, it doesn't matter which. Once again, I find it easiest to roll through and then step back, and this time start to move towards his face, so that while you're throwing. With Combustion, when you do Combustion, you're stuck in place, but with the Fireballs, you've got a little bit of movement. And then we can use the Homeward Bone to go back, and you can activate it kind of before you get the souls. You've got quite a lot of time there. And next up is Sens. So from here, you can pretty much just level Vitality for the rest of the game until you get to the end, and we'll put a little bit more in Attunement. But effectively, just level Vitality to whatever you want it to. And then if you want to put any in Endurance, you can. But I mostly fits great. So with Sens, I've done it in a bit more detail in my other video, so I'll do it a bit quicker here. Effectively with Sens, you want to try and go at full pelt all the way through, because it times all the blades really nicely. And you want to have a full stamina bar and run into the flat of the blade as it passes. And then once it clears you, you'll run out the other side. The reason you want to start running is because it takes you a while to get up to speed. So if you're running against the flat of the blade, then you'll come out at full pace. Here, we peek around the corner and then double back. And we can take that first blast on the wall. And then that times us really nicely for the second blast to go into the swinging axis. And then we can just run around. When we get to this bit here, if you've been hit, this is the time when you would want to drink Estus, and then you can run forward. Here, just run forward past the table, duck left, and then run up the slope to the right. We're going to do a quit out. You can quit out a bit earlier if you're not quite as quick on your quit outs, and then reload, and the boulder will be redirected. Run to the top of the slope and duck back round to the left. Here, shield up, hug the left wall, and you'll go straight past the arrows. Here, just time it right, and as you run through close to the first blade, you'll be able to push through. And this is the one snake man that you're going to have to hit to get him out your way. Be careful rounding that corner, as it's quite easy to come out at an angle. And here, same again, just run into the flat of the blade, you'll come out at full speed and be able to go straight through. We don't need anything in Sens at all, so we're just going to run straight through to the boss. This bit's reasonably easy to run through, so for me personally, I tend to use my middle finger to hold down the circle button and run, and then I use my thumb and forefinger to manipulate the camera so that I can keep running all the way through and don't have to change the camera using my thumb, so I can continue to run. Not super great at it in that section there. There, just punch the guy to get him out of the way, equip a flame and go through. But with Iron Golem, same as always, we're going to duck to the right so that his smash hits on the rocks. We go behind him, and we want to use two combustions on his left leg and one on his right. You want to stand behind his left leg to get the angle to make him fall. We do one more, and then he tips off. So unfortunately, I missed the first flame there. And here I get a little bit impatient and a bit greedy. But we've got loads of vitality, so we can tank it. And now we're at Anor Londo. for Anor Londo, all we're going to do is run through. We need to rest at this bonfire so that we can come back to it for Seath later. So rest here. I don't spend my souls, but I think I just forgot. So you can certainly do it here. It's quicker not to, because you're going to spend them later. But also, if you're not confident carrying around 40k in souls, feel free to just level, keep pumping Vit, basically, until you get up to 40, I think, or whatever you want. We're going to run for the lift. On the lift, we've got time to pop one soul from our inventory and then jump. So we're going to try to jump onto the lift and then get the soul of Sif and use it. And then that will time us nicely to do a little circle and run off the lift onto the railing and jump down. There is another jump you can do here straight onto that kind of buttress, but it's quite easy, but I just can't stand the thought of losing a run to it, so I always just drop down. I think I'm also a bit of a coward. So now we're going to do rafters. We want to have our flame out and great combustion in case anything goes wrong. So that means we can just drop the Painted Guardians if anything goes pear-shaped. This looks a lot harder than it actually is. So all you want to do is run forward. You need to have your shield up. So after you get past that guy, you let your stamina regenerate. And then you need to have your shield up here. And then we go for the jump. And for whatever reason, I don't jump. I thought I pressed the button, but I didn't. So we quit out to do a save, and that means we're just gonna... now we don't have our momentum, so we'll just take on that Guardian, and we'll kill him with combustion. So that's why we've got great combustion and our Pyromancy flame out, just in case. And we can drop down instead. But the rafters can be a massive source of frustration in any playthrough. But if you're not trying to fight them, it's really easy to run. If you just make a save file, so get to the rafters, quit out, back up your save or mark it as read-only, and then when you load in, you'll be there, and if you quit out the game, you can copy the save back, or if it's read-only, your position won't be updated, and you can just practice that, and within 10 or 15 minutes, you'll be able to run it kind of 95% of the time without any problems. So here we've got the giant at the top. He only really has two attacks, I think, generally. He will either do a vertical slash down or a horizontal swipe. Here we get the vertical slash, which you don't need to dodge. If it's the horizontal swipe, you need to roll it. To do this bit, I just use Lobos's strat of a double roll. And that mostly goes okay. Maybe one time in three it doesn't work out. But it seems to be the most consistent. Here... you can just run straight through. You do need to be careful about getting hit in the back, like that. And here, it just doubles me. I know Sanso, I think it's Sanso, he turns the camera around and runs towards the camera so that he can time his roll. I find that too stressful for this stage of the game. But I might try and stop doing that in future. Then here, we can use two great combustions to kill this knight. But it's easier if we can just get him to kill himself. So we get him to go melee, and we back up, and then he walks off the corner as he charges. So you need to kind of maintain that consistent distance to get him walking towards you, and then get him to try and either stab you or shield bash you as he gets to the corner. And that's pretty much it. So we're going to get here. You'll want a level of vitality, so hopefully you manage to pop a soul on the elevator, so you can at least get that to get a couple of levels, and then we can push on to ONS. Great. Thanks very much for watching, guys. Catch you in part 3.